When I need new piston? And this is really good question, because when we are thinking that when I need new piston in my car, there is really good this rule and order. It is only thing that we need to measure this our pistons, this diameter in here. And then if this diameter is too small, then we purchase new piston. And there is really possible that in many cars, like in that my car, there is even possibility to purchase bigger pistons, because when we look in that area, there is small stamp in here. There's P letter in here. And let's go to look closer. Now we can see in here, there is P letter in here. And that means that this is now in this central sides of piston. And then there is also A letter piston, what is a little bit smaller. And C letter is of course bigger, this piston. But in now my case, when I have this P letter, there is only issue that this is like worn out. And how these pistons worn out? Pistons normally worn out in these sides areas. In here, when we look, we can see in their scratches. And in like in that my case, there has been worn out this aluminium material about amount, what is like 0 amount, and I will calculate that next. And this piston's diameter should be 88.5 this millimeters, and I will write that in down. And that means that there is this amount, 88.5 millimeters. And now it means that diameter, that amount, what is in from that piston sides from here to here, this inner area. And when we look in that my piston, it means that diameter from here to here. Now I can do in here small markings, because this my pencil is suitable for piston markings. It means that this amount here to here, and this must be this 80, when this my piston is new, it is 88.5 millimeters, this area, 88, and it is in here this amount. And let's look that what is this my piston's diameter now, because this piston is now old, about 15 years old, and there is mileage now this 200,000 miles. And that means that this piston has been moved in that kind of this distance, what we can calculate next June. And I will say that what is this, how many miles this my piston has been run. Because now this my engine is about 200,000 miles. Is this my car's this drive amount. And how much has been this piston runs in up and down. And what is this burnout ratio? And I will soon calculate my estimation that how much this piston has been moved in here. Okay, and now I have really made in like informative thing that how many miles this my piston has been run and moved when this my car has been moved this 200,000 miles. If my car has been run 200,000 miles, how much this my piston has been moved, because this piston runs normally 3000 revs per minute if we drive in 80 miles per hour. There is this my calculation. This my piston, it has been run 30 million miles, piston miles. This piston has been run really 30 million miles, this movement, what means in that kind of movement, up and down in this way. And it is huge amount of these revs, and in that thing, this material worn out in here, especially in here, and let's go to look those scratches. And in here we can see very small sandpaper scratches, and these scratches, they have became in here because of this contact between this piston and cylinder block, this tube, what is metal, steel. And that's this my piston has been worn out, and let's go to measure that how much there is material loss. Then when we measure this amount in here, that kind of measurement scale, it is too hard, and there is, this is not enough, this accuracy, when we measure in like that way. In here we can see that it is about 80, just 8.8 millimeters maybe, but this is not suitable, and that's we need more accurate this measurement tool, and it looks like that. And let's go to look this closer. And this tool name is micrometer. Micrometer, and there is this scale numbers in here. We can see, and when I rotate that screw and that knob in here, then this measurement part moves in here in that way. And now when I rotate, it moves nicely in here. And I have to move that almost away in that way, because I need to now measure this my piston sides. And this sides measurement happens so that I take measurement in this central line, central area, and I can actually do in here small markings in here and in here, that in these points I set up this my tool and I measure that how much there is this material. And let's go to look that when I rotate that, then this amount moves, and this side area in here, this point, it tells this diameter in here. And let's go to do that job closer. Okay, and now we can see these both lines, and now I set up this my tool carefully in this area, and then I start to rotate that in here in that way, and then this my tool moves, and let's look a little bit better. We can see this better, bigger view, and now I rotate that my tool, and let's look, and there's idea that when it's this part stops, I have to rotate only very gentle, very sensitive movements, no force. And now I go forward, and let's go to look that area, because this is this contact point. Now we have nice view, very near, we can see that when this my micrometer goes nicely. In same time, this my tool starts to click in here. This is really important that when this movement stops, normally it moves, but then when there is enough this thing, this starts to click, look. And then this movement stops. This only clicks. And this is micrometers, this very important rule that I have to move in here, and then we go to look that scale. And then we need to read that scale in here. And this needs really bit accuracy, because there are those markings in here, and let's go to look that even closer. And now when we look this measurement scale, there is idea that these amounts, they are millimeters, and then these small dots, or these lines, they are these next millimeters, like this is 85, big amount, and then this next line is 86, 87, and in here it is 88, that point. And then we have to look in that down area, in here, that because in that down area there is also lines, that in what line we are looking in here. And now when we look in this area, we have to look that second line in here, and these are like half amounts, half, 0.5 steps, and now I can see that there is one step is in here, and it means that we have 1, 2, and then half in here, and that means that 87.5, and then I have to add this amount in here, 87.5 put and plus 40, and this means that now this my piston area is 87.9 millimeters, and I have to write that down. Now there is situation that this piston should be in that amount, but this my piston is only 87.9 millimeters. And now this is so small when we compare. This is like when we compare that new one diameter. It is like 0. Diff is like 0.6 millimeters. And this amount is too much. Too much. Because when we look in this service book, I go to check that what is this maximum amount what we can get. I think that 0.6 millimeters is too much, and that means that this my piston is too much burn out, and I need to get new piston what is like in that size. But I go to check that how much we can have this diff, because my piston should be in that diameter, and now it is only 87 this area from here to here, like in here to here. And let's look at what this amount should be. Okay, and now I check this information, and max diff is only 0.1 millimeters. 0.1, and now my diff is 0.6, and that means that this my piston is too small. Okay, and now really, this my piston is too small. This should be size 88.5, but this my piston is only, when I write in here this amount, it is only 87.9 millimeters here. And that means now that this my piston is too small. There is so much this scratch sandpapering, like sandpapering, that this my piston is too small, and I need to now replace new piston. And then this my piston is in this manufacturer's in this oil clearance amount, but it's only 0.5. Okay, that kind of information, my friend, and please enjoy and learn more.